Hello there, guys. It's Stephen here. That was a disappointment, wasn't it? My biggest fear about a week ago was that we'd have some disastrous week that totally threatened to undermine our season and we'd lose three games. And guess what happened? That was frustrating, wasn't it? It's weird, though, and this tone in the video probably isn't what you're going to be expecting. Because, strangely, I came away from that game last night, and maybe it was because I expected to go out. I came away from the game strangely proud of the team. I actually genuinely believe that they left everything out on the pitch there last night. Even though we weren't perfect, I still think every single one of those players, they really, really tried. They ran until the end, but they just looked absolutely spent by about the 60th minute. And it was a game where we gave it all, but it wasn't just quite good enough in the end. It's a weird tie, a tie marred by controversy. I guess most big Champions League games are. Guardiola obviously was sent off through his frustration. Welcome to life, not at Barca or Bayern there, Pep, actually, where referees don't tend to favour your sides. And we had a perfectly good goal disallowed. Obviously, we had a perfectly good goal disallowed in the first leg as well. And it made you think, what? Now, I just want to add a disclaimer. I'm not trying to say for any Liverpool fans watching this that they didn't deserve to go through. They probably did in general. They were probably the more clinical team, probably defended better than we did, and they're definitely more clinical going forward. So, fair play to them. They are through, and they probably just about deserved it. What I am saying is, though, at key moments, big things happened that could have changed the course of the tie, and it is frustrating. After we looked to try and perform a miracle last night, given the fact that we were disallowed a perfectly good goal in the first leg, which would have given the away goal cushion that we probably needed, well, we were always going to have an uphill battle. But we came firing out the blocks. Gabriel Jesus obviously got on the end of Raheem Sterling's cross and scored a third minute winner. Cue delirium in the stands. I thought maybe we could actually do this. And then we were largely exceptional in that first 45. We were all over Liverpool. We couldn't quite unlock the door. And when we finally did, it was ruled out for offside. Now, that to me, it was a totally legitimate goal. Obviously, the ball came off Milner. We don't need to discuss that. We know by now, and the referees have come out as well in the press saying that it was a goal, perfectly good. That could have been huge for us. When we needed a little bit of luck, we just didn't get it. We were 2-0 at half-time. All of a sudden, the game is a different one. Liverpool maybe started to get a little bit more anxious, started to sit a little bit deeper, and the fans started to fear the worst. As it is, it didn't happen, and by the 60th minute, we kind of ran out of ideas, and Liverpool capitalised on our tiring defence, our general desperation, and they took the game away from us. Fair play to them. Mohamad Salah, he certainly knows how to finish, and they are so clinical going forward. I was sat with Paul, used to be on Blue Horizon, during that second half, and I was saying the movement between Firmino, Mane and Salah is just so intelligent. They know how to sneak out a chance at the smallest and tightest of areas. They're so good, and fair play to them. That is a hell of a forward line, and they're through now. But it does make you think, what could have been if we had a little bit of luck? We've been absolutely hugely unfortunate with some decisions in the past three games. Obviously, the penalty that should have happened with Aguero against United, and obviously disallowed goals and all that kind of stuff. But that is football, I guess. And a large part of the blame does fall on us in general for these games. We've given away cheap goals, we've given away very soft moments, and let comfortable positions slip. That's on us as a team. Maybe we tinker with the team too much as well. That's it. But what I do want to tell you, go back to the start of the video, I was weirdly proud. I thought the fans were excellent last night. Even when we went 2-1 down, there was a rousing rendition of Blue Moon with all the scarves being held up. And that was like a show of solidarity, and I loved that. I want to see more nights like that at the Etihad, because it was so good hearing the fans get behind the team, because they knew that team deserved it. Pep was right to say the team's extraordinary, because it's easy to forget how good we've been this season. We've had a disastrous 7 days, but it doesn't change the fact that we've been absolutely spectacular so far this season. We are 13 points clear for a reason. I'm going to finish the season, in my opinion, almost definitely 99% certain, with two trophies. By far the best team in the Premier League and the League Cup. It's a pretty good season. Who knows, if we get a left back next season, Mendy, welcome back when you come back, and maybe make one or two more tweaks, maybe slightly bolster the squad, because the players look tired now at this stage of the season. Maybe we can make an assault on the Champions League next year. We can't win everything all the time. We're maybe not built to be the perfect cup competition team, but we are built for the long haul. And Pep is still building a team that's going to take on all comers. It's disappointing, do not get me wrong, but the players, they worked really, really hard last night. A special shout out to Raheem Sterling, who ran. He ran constantly. He was absolutely excellent. His desire, his work rate, his attitude, I was so impressed with Raheem last night. In a big game, he really tried to show up. Not everything he tried came up, but his attitude was exceptional. And Sané as well. He really gave it to Liverpool. I know he didn't have his most productive game, but he's once again, his attitude was fantastic. I lost count the amount of times I saw him track back and win a ball in defence and so on. Little things like that happened. He's only a young lad, so he'll make mistakes still. But his attitude was spot on last night, and all the players really gave it a go, as did Bernardo Silva, De Bruyne, all that lot. They just looked a bit out on the legs in the end. That's just how it is. We got tired at the business end of the season. We got a little bit of bad luck, a tiny bit of lack of concentration, and maybe one or two players have dropped out of form at the same time. It was going to happen. It's happened for other teams this season. It's happened for us now. Pep isn't a fraud. Pep's a fantastic manager. This team isn't overrated. It's a fantastic team, but it is still a work in progress. And I was saying that weeks ago, even when we were romping to the league, I was still saying we're a work in progress and we're going to get better next season. I still believe that. Guys, it's disappointing, but it isn't that bad. It isn't that bad. We're still very lucky to be blessed with this team. It's still a fantastic team. And the players did give their all last night. It was just too big a mountain to climb after the disaster that was Anfield. Guys, sorry for the delayed reaction, but I like to take a bit of time to think about a game before I get my thoughts down. And today, I felt proud of the team, and you should too. Anyway, guys, I'll see you for Spurs preview tomorrow or Friday. See you in a bit.